I love the video so much. Completely G-rated. So it's not like, oh, you can't show your kids that. It's a half-naked woman and the guy's getting, you know, shot. And just, well, I guess someone does get shot in that video, but it's the most comical part of the whole video. And the cops bust in and get him up against the wall and he goes, eh.
Their sense of humor strikes me most of all. The sheer creativity.
I think we'll look back on the 80s and MTV and all that popping up and say, man, that was a lot of hairspray and jive ass and, oh, and the residents were there. What the fuck was that happening there?
The video for Hello Skinny scared the shit out of me.
I'd never seen a music video, but it kind of made sense. Well, we'll do a short film to just a song.
Skinny was born in a bathtub and grew so incredibly thin that even the end of an eyedropper sucked him in.
I'd gotten this guy, Bridget, who was a ward at a halfway house run by a transsexual in my neighborhood, evil transsexuals. And the problem with Bridget was, he was living kind of on the edge. So he decided he's gonna clean up his act. He came to me and he said, Grandma, I decided to go home to see my mother, live with my mother. And that was the next day we're gonna shoot. You know, Bridget, you can't do that. No, I'm going home. I'm leaving on the bus today. So I got him into the studio really quickly, shot his face in every angle I could, and then walked with him down to the bus stop, shooting them all away. And that was Hella Skinny.
They never bothered to have smoke machines and women in knit stockings.
Someone saw a strange amount of moisture on her lips.
They worked in total opposition to that. I think that one part of their legacy will be that they found and were able to establish meaning within this completely corrupted form. And kind of prosper through that rather than collapse into it like, you know, so many other bands did.